What's up? Merite here, and in this video, we will be going through the procedure on how we divide the abdomen into 9 distinct regions, because as you're studying the organs in the abdominal cavity, you will most probably see the word holotopy, which means the relation between the organ and the body as a whole. And by describing the holotopy of an organ, you will be stating at which region the organ is located. So let's start by dividing the abdominal region into 2 horizontal lines first. We call these the upper horizontal plane and the lower horizontal plane. The upper horizontal plane is at the lowest point of the costal arch and is therefore also called the subcostal plane, while the lower horizontal plane is between the spina iliaca anterior superior, so the lower horizontal plane is sometimes also called the interspinal plane. This will divide the abdomen into 3 levels using this arch right here that the lower edges of the rib cartilage form. That's the distance between the ribs called Distantia Costarum. Now we get an upper level above this arch. We got a middle level under the costal arch until the interspinous plane. And then under the interspinous plane, you will find the lower level. And now we need to add the vertical lines. And we add them using the rectus abdominis muscle, as you see here. And the way we add the vertical lines is along this muscle, along the musculus rectus abdominis. It starts down here at the pubic tubercle, then it goes along the rectus abdominis, and then reaches approximately the middle point of the clavicle up here. So now we got 9 distinct regions, right? At the upper level, we get the epigastric region and the right and the left hypochondriac region on either side beneath the ribs. And then we get the middle level, we get the umbilical region in the middle, since the umbilicus or the navel is here in the middle. And then the laterally, we got the right and the left lateral regions. And then at the lower regions, we got the pubic region and the right and the left inguinal region, or sometimes also referred to as the right and left iliac region. So this is what we call the 9 region scheme. Now, as you're studying the abdomen, you might find some sources using the 4 quadrant scheme. But now, why is it important to divide the abdomen into regions? The human abdomen is divided into quadrants and regions by anatomists and physicians for the purpose of study, diagnosis, and treatment. Imagine if there's a pain in and tenderness, any scars, any lumps, or other items of interest. The division allows you to locate and narrow in at which organs and tissue may be involved, which could help you form differential diagnoses. So here I've added a list of all organs you will find within these 9 regions. And with that being said, let's go through the detailed anatomy of all the organs in the abdominal cavity.